JBN, we keep you informed. I am Michelle Jones, and in the news, it looks like suicide, but his parents say he was murdered. Please remember to subscribe, like, share, leave us a comment, and click the notification bell to receive our daily news items. The family of a popular Westmoreland promoter who allegedly killed himself after shooting his girlfriend and his best friend in a bizarre incident early yesterday morning says they believe he was murdered and the story fabricated as a cover-up. The parents of 28-year-old Daniel Porter, also known as Fats, are insisting that their son was murdered as he was not a man prone to violence. According to head of the Westmoreland Police Division, Superintendent Robert Gordon, preliminary reports are that about 4 a.m. yesterday, Porter and his girlfriend, who were at the Chantilly Gardens premises close to his home, had an altercation when he brandished a firearm and shot her in the arm. Upon hearing the gunshot, his best friend, who is also the landlord, went to investigate, and during a tussle between both men, the firearm went off and his friend was shot in one of his legs. It is alleged that Porter then ran into a bathroom where he shot himself in the side of his head, resulting in his death. His girlfriend and best friend were both treated at hospital and released. "We are doing all that is necessary as it relates to scientific work by way of swabbing. The ballistic test will be done, etc. But as it stands, it is the information that we have," Superintendent Gordon said yesterday. "Based on the preliminary information that we have, one thing that we know for sure is that three persons received gunshot wounds, one died. That is what is positive, and it is alleged that the person that died took his own life. That aspect is still under investigation to determine if it is so or not," Superintendent Gordon added. But Porter's father, Donald, refuses to believe that his son had the courage to kill himself. "Them say a suicide, but him too coward for do them things there. As you lift your hand, him run, go hide. Them murder my son," the grief-stricken father said. The father alleged that his son was shot in the left side of his head and questioned how a right-handed person should manage to carry out such an act. "I kill them, kill him," the father insisted. However, the police said the younger Porter was shot in the right side of his head, which is consistent with the suspected suicide. At the same time, his mother, Andrea Gray, who bemoaned the loss of her only child, contends that he never owned a gun. "Them same shoot the girl in her hand, one of them name foot and shoot himself, and him don't have no gun, so him don't know where the gun come from," she argued. Gray said that at about 9 p.m. on Wednesday, Daniel, who lived with her, left their house to go to premises across the road where he usually hangs out with friends in the evenings. She recounted that at her behest, he promised to return early. She said that she woke up about 3 a.m. with a headache and went into the bathroom to get a bit of garlic when she heard explosions coming from the neighbor's house. "Me hear explosion, but me thinks that they were knocking pieces of board together. It was after me hear a commotion outside that me get concerned and me call Daniel's phone, but him never answer," said Gray. The mother said that she then called the girlfriend of Daniel's best friend, who was also in the house next door. "Me never hear her, and then she called me back and said, 'Girl, shooting, shooting, shooting,'" Gray said. The frightened mother said she ran outside just in time to see Daniel's girlfriend and his friend being rushed off to the hospital. "Same time, we run over there in a minute, and see everybody sitting in the veranda. And Mr. Where my son?" "Them said Daniel in the bathroom," she related, adding that she went into the bathroom where she found her son's slumped, blooded body. The distraught mother said her son was not a known troublemaker. "Daniel is a quiet person. Him not give me no trouble rather than him love to drink rum. Me can't tell her that. Him love him rum. Him love him liquor drinking. My son don't really get trouble. No, him not them type of person there. Him is a loving, nice person," she said. Some residents believe that, based on recent developments between the deceased man and his girlfriend, he could have carried out the act as he was upset that she was ending their relationship. Superintendent Gordon used the tragedy to urge persons to seek professional help to deal with domestic disputes instead of resorting to violence. JBN, we keep you informed. Please remember to subscribe, like, share, leave us a comment, and click the notification bell to receive our daily news items.